The DeLorean sports car was manufactured in Northern Ireland in the early 1980s. With gull-wing doors and brushed stainless steel panels, the DeLorean was known for its flashy style. Today, many of these cars are in rough shape, but a restoration can make a DeLorean look like new. This DeLorean is a rare relic from the 80s. Only 9,080 of these iconic cars were manufactured. No longer operational, this DeLorean might have been destined for the junkyard. But with professional restoration, this company has the spare parts to get it up and running. The process starts with the diagnostics. The technician examines the suspension, the steering rack, and brakes. He finds significant deterioration and documents his findings. He scrutinizes every part of the old DeLorean and produces an 11-page report on its condition. Once all the problems have been identified, the mechanic gets to work, removing plugs to drain some of the coolant. He disassembles many pipes and hoses that run coolant from the radiator to the rear engine. Many of the coolant pipes will need to be cleaned in order to be reused. The rubber hoses can't be salvaged and will need replacement. The mechanic disassembles the brakes. The calipers are in bad shape, but can be rebuilt. The rusty rotors are still thick enough that they can be resurfaced. After mounting new tires and refinishing the cast alloy wheels, another technician bolts them to the hubs. He lowers the hoist and sets the car on the floor. He tightens the lug nuts to the final torque setting. A technician begins disassembling the rear drive engine. In order to know what needs to be replaced, the technician must take the engine apart. He removes the air filter box in order to access the intake manifold. Then he unbolts the W-shaped manifold pipe that splits the airflow to the engine. Once it's off, he removes the air mixture control unit, which needs restorative work. With the unit out of the way, he can easily get to other parts that need replacing or fixing. Those include spark plugs, wires, vacuum lines, the distributor cap, and rotor. Under the front hood, the mechanic pulls the fuel pump out of the gas tank to check for deterioration. It's beyond repair. He drains any fuel that remains in the tank. After the gas tank has been emptied and cleaned, he inserts a new modern-style pump module. Another technician holds the top of the pump down as the module is clamped into place. Next, the technician removes the interior door panels and uses a central tester to operate the power windows. He confirms the power windows are functional. He also checks the power locks and mirrors to verify that they're working properly. He pulls off exterior rubber trim. He shaves off any remaining rubber bits. This allows room to repair a dent in the stainless steel body. He files the area around the dent to remove some scratches. He places a special tool over the dent. It has a rod with a fine steel tip that welds to the body, providing a solid grip as he manually pulls out the dent. Meanwhile, another mechanic applies tape to various sections of the car to establish borders for the refinishing of the steel body panels. He sands out any imperfections or tool marks from the repairs and restores the brushed finish bumper to bumper. Since no paint can be used to cover up repairs on bare stainless steel, the bodywork must be done perfectly. Inside, technicians reupholster the seats and treat any discoloration in the vinyl panels and dashboard. Finally, the entire car gets an extensive exterior cleaning. It's taken months to restore this DeLorean, but the question remains, will it run like a new car? Once tested in various driving conditions, mechanics confirm that this 1980s throwback is ready for its comeback.